Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the CMA channel. Today we have a super guest, absolutely amazing composer. I never met that man, and it's the first time I met him. I just discovered him through his composition by some superb artist. Please welcome on Zoom with us live the super composer Artem Nizhnik. Hello, nice to see you.
Hello. Guten Tag, meine Damen und Herren. Danke, dass Sie uns heute. Ich spreche nicht sehr gut Englisch, darum mit mir ist heute Ekaterina Vinogradova, eine Akkordeonistin und einfach eine nette Person, und sie wird mein Dolmetscher heute. So, einfach, ich hoffe, dass mehr Leute wissen Deutsch als Russisch.
So, so you can translate. Hello, Ekaterina.
Я просто рад всех видеть.
Artem Alexandrovich is happy to see everyone today with us.
Okay. But I think Artem, if you want, you can speak to her in Russian, no? If you want.
Okay.
Yeah, because Ekaterina, you are from Russia or from Germany?
From Russia.
From Russia, so I think it's better. It's much more lovely language, you know, Russian is fantastic. So, before we begin the interview, I would like to listen one first video you sent to us, and I would like you to speak a little bit about your composition, because you compose for solos, but you compose for orchestras, and this is an accordion orchestra, it's very interesting. So please, can you present the first scherzo you composed?
Это скерцо из маленького триптиха.
This is the scherzo from Little Triptych.
Которое я написал по заказу латвийского оркестра.
Which was ordered by the Latvian orchestra.
И великолепного дирижера Татьяны Саратовой.
And magnificent conductor Татьяна Саратова.
Это обязательное произведение для конкурса, который проходит в Даугавпилс раз в год.
This is a necessary composition for contest in Daugavpils, which takes place every year.
Okay, so we listen immediately and come back to you. Thank you. composition Scherzo from Artem Nizhnik. And Artem Malkachian, you have very good choice on your composition and also on the choice of your concertist, because Artem Malkachian is one of the best actually in the world who won all competitions. He won last year Trophée Mondial in category Senior Classic also. He won this year this Castelfidardo competition too. And he will be also with you on the jury of this category Trophée Mondial the 20th of December. Okay, and perhaps some things you don't know, but I think you will be interested to learn that, and also the people who look at that Facebook live show now, because many of them are candidates, that for the next year, I said yesterday, but for the next year on the Trophée Mondial, in beginning to the year to June, we will make national selection everywhere. And then in September, we will continue this Facebook live online like that. The Trophée Mondial will be totally online. But in November, we will make it in Truskavets in Ukraine, and we will have some concerto to play. So this summer, Artem, I will invite you again for full, only you for 1 hour, and you will present your concerto to propose to the candidate. You understand?
Okay, yes, yes, with pleasure.
Хорошо. Okay, so can you speak a little bit about you and where you come from, with who you made your studies? Because when we become to be adult, we must not forget our previous teacher. So you can speak about where do you come from and who was your teacher, for example.
Я учился в Донецке.
Артём Александрович studied in Donetsk.
У профессора Воеводина.
At the class of professor Воеводин.
И также учился у прекрасного педагога, может быть, величайшего Эльзбет Мозер.
And his teacher, his another teacher was,
Эльзбет Мозер, of course, the lady of the accordion world.
И в композиции Александра Карастоянова.
And his composition teacher was Александр Карастоянов.
Карастоянова.
Карастоянова.
At the Wiener Freiner Conservatory. И Сергей Мамонов, Донецкий.
Сергей Мамонов, Донецк.
Okay, and after mm-hmm. you have been, did you yourself compete in some international competitions?
Yes. okay, at the Klingenthal in 2003.
2003.
Number 4, I was.
Okay. In this category, number 4, you were number 4.
In categories, okay, senior classic.
Number 4, yeah. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Astana Grand Prix at Kiev, number 3. So.
Okay.
I was still man.
Great, and but you play fantastically, because now we will listen to you performing something that for the sensitive people like me, it's not easy to listen, because I will be crying, because this music is absolutely deep, fantastic, and the way you play it, it's also very, very sensitive. So what is the name? The Hill of Crosses, that's it.
Я должен сказать, что это был первый раз, когда я свою музыку вообще играл.
It was the first time Artem played his own music.
Это по просьбе Фридриха Ликса.
It was requested by Friedrich Licks.
На прошлогоднем фестивале Баянный баянист.
At the last contest.
Баянный баянист.
Баянный баянист.
Аккордеонист.
И эта пьеса не о чем-то грустном, но.
This piece isn't about something sad. Something sad.
Но в одном месте в Литве около Шауляя.
But in one place in Lithuania, near the
Шауляй. Куда люди приходят попросить о чем-то Бога или.
Where people come to ask something from God.
Или поблагодарить.
Or thank. God.
И приносят свои кресты.
And bring their crosses to this place.
И это фантастически выглядит.
It looks fantastically.
Okay, so we listen, and just before we listen, I just want to say hello to a few people on the chat who just arrived. Laurence Poissard, of course, she's there every day, but also Igor Sayenko. Igor Sayenko will be our guest live tonight. Igor Sayenko is a friend of everybody, but he's so sympathetic boy, and so efficient, so active, so good musician. And tonight he will present us the 2021 Trophée Mondial in Truskavets. We will see live the hotel, the mayor, the rector, the delegates, the room of the competition, the municipality, everything. So hello Igor Sayenko, Julie Blocher, and Vladimir Stupnikov is also with us. And we listen now the Hill of Crosses for Bayan, composed by Artem Nizhnik and played by Artem Nizhnik.
Thank you.
Thank you. You are a very dangerous composer. Wow, such emotion. It's so impressive. And when you play, you are everywhere on your music, your breath, your sentences, we follow you. I just realized that in my paper, you wrote to me, you can stop at 4 minutes. But where was this 4 minute? I never see a fourth minute. We just arrived 8 minutes later and it's... Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Bravo. And I don't understand why I never had access to your composition before. Because when did you compose that music?
When it happened?
2 years ago.
Ah, see, it's enough recent. That's why. Okay, because we never know in this Trophée Mondial Senior Classique, we never know which piece to play, like cantiliana, like this. You know, first round is a baroque, virtuosic, and cantiliana. We never know what to choose because everybody played this one or this one. That one, I promise, next year they will all play that one, like test piece, because it's fantastic. Okay. Thank you. Спасибо. Огромное спасибо.
Ноты абсолютно бесплатно на моей странице есть.
The score is absolutely free at the page of Tom Nizhnik.
Okay. Which page? Facebook page or what?
Facebook.
Okay. Good to know. Good to know. Thank you so much. So now we will change style. We will change also artist with Irina Serotyuk, which is a new delegate for CMA for Sweden. And I am so happy of that because the first time on the history. So she also changed country. Like we have this Ilya, who is also now in Israel. She is there and everybody moved from Ukraine. But this talent is enormous. And she will play one of your composition again, and I think that Ekaterina, she's playing also on that group.
Yes.
She's not only beautiful and translator, she is also musician. So can you present a little bit that music, please?
Эта сюита называется «Колыбельные для Элианы».
This suite called «Lullabies for Eliana».
Я думаю, 6 лет назад или 7 лет назад.
About 6 or 7 years ago.
Музыканты из Филадельфийского симфонического оркестра.
Musicians from Philadelphian Philharmonic Orchestra.
Попросили меня написать что-то для ребенка.
Asked Artem to write something for a child.
К сожалению, этот ребенок был очень болен.
This child was ill, seriously.
Ее звали Элиана, эта девочка.
Her name was Eliana.
Я подумал, что можно написать такого для ребенка.
Artem was thinking what he could write for a child.
Чтобы стало немножко лучше.
To become a little easier for her.
И написал 4 колыбельных.
And he wrote 4 lullabies.
И назвал «Колыбельные для Элианы». Это очень необычный состав, потому что это был заказ. Инструментальный микс,
we understand.
Арпа, скрипка и баян.
Harp, violin and accordion.
Okay.
И сейчас вторая часть.
Now it is the second part.
Колыбельная звезд.
The star lullaby stars.
Lullaby of the stars from the suite Lullaby of Iliana for Bayan violin and harp. We listen immediately. That second movement.
Thank you.
Lullaby of the Stars, absolutely lovely composition again by Artem Niznich. Congratulations again. And now we will now go with two of my best Russian friends. They are genial artists, absolutely genial artists. They are absolutely crazy. They play all kind of music, modern music, pop music, world music, whatever. They are already winners, of course, of the CMA competition in chamber music and world music. These guys, it's Sib Duo. We will listen them now in one composition of you, and you are a little bit frozen. I don't know. For one time, it's not my connection. My connection now is perfect because of Michel Gachet. So I think you, okay. You are unblocked now. You were a little bit frozen, no problem. So can you speak a little bit about that composition, Lines of Heart, please?
Два назад мои друзья, Саша Сиропкин и Александр и Андрей Битюцкий, попросили меня написать для них что-то с оркестром.
2 years ago, his friends Alexander Sirotkin and Andrei Bitutskikh asked Artem to write something to play in this orchestra.
Я был тогда в Венгрии, находился как раз.
Artem was in Hungary at that moment.
И просто много мыслей пришло хороших.
And a lot of good ideas and thoughts came to him.
Я написал для них это сочинение. Оно посвящено им как исполнителям.
This composition is dedicated to Sib Duo.
И также моей супруге.
And Artem's wife.
Вот. И по линии сердца. Ну, что испытывает человек.
Yeah, so the lines of the heart is about what person can feel.
Okay, so
what?
Okay, you have a Russian fantastic internet connection, but here the connection is good, so we will listen immediately to that and continue the interview just after. Sib Duo in action. It's absolutely everything what I love. Absolutely everything. This energy, this fantasy, this, it's deep and light at the same time. It's a, and these two artists are crazy and you are crazy. Such a meeting for me today, such a discovery. Artem, really, I'm so, so happy and so much emotion also from the beginning. Okay, I think we will keep in touch very soon for many things. That's clear. So,
thank you.
Pajalosta, big. Pajalosta, enormous. And see you the 20th of December live with all the best accordionists in the planet for the final of the category Senior Classic of the Trophée Mondial. Okay, with Richard Galliano, yes. The Richard Galliano, who will be there online with us with so many winners from Trophée Mondial, Klingenthal, Coupe Mondial, Castelfidardo, everywhere. And such composers, we are very lucky and proud. So thank you very much. I let you go because someone else is waiting now that you know very well. It's Mr. Massimo Piggini. So we'll make the interview with him. He will say something very interesting about the accordion as well. Artem, congratulations again and bye-bye. Ekaterina, bye-bye.
Thank you very much.
My pleasure. So Mr. Piggini, you are here. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you. You hear me?
Yes, I see you, I hear you. I just have a small adjustment to do because Artem and Ekaterina was two and I put me on the middle, but now I will do something magical. Whoopla! And you, wait, because I can do the same for you. Whoopla! We don't stop the technique. I will finish Spielberg at the end of the year, you will see. It's up to you.
You changed your work now, not more music. Now you are a regist.
Yeah, but you know, of course.
A movie maker.
Exactly. But you know, before competition, normally an accordion teacher don't have job because the work is done the whole year. So we can adapt. So what is the subject today? What is the surprise for us?
We can choose many subjects. If you want, we can speak about story, or we can just spend 5-10 minutes speaking about a small accordion.
You have
always
it in there.
Made a small accordion.
Okay, let's go to the small accordion. I follow.
Because normally we are speaking every time about the big accordion, about the serious, about the nova, about concert instrument. Today we can spend a few minutes speaking about an instrument like that is for a young student, about 5-6 years old. And what is interesting is that it's made like the big instrument. That is the difference, because always the artists are very interested on the kind of wood we use for our accordion, for the accordion, our in Piggini, but the accordion all over the world. And the answer is quite complicated, because we don't use one wood, but we use 10, 12 different wood in each accordion.
I never heard about that.
Why we use so many kind of wood? Because the accordion is quite a complicated instrument, because it's acoustic, it's aerophone, but it's portable and should be used in many places around the world. It should be used in Finland, where we have for 100 days no humidity, zero. And should be used in Brazil, where we have 250 days every year with humidity at 70%. So our instrument needed to use many different wood. For example, in this small Peter Pan that we are here, I hope that you can see well.
Perfectly. We see you like if we are with you on the same place.
We have a skin around the instrument, this part, that in fact is not wood, but is play wood. So we have 5-piece slice of wood glue in five different direction, orthogonal, and that is one, the skin is very strong against deformation, against change of size, because the wood, when I glue one wood in this direction and the other wood in this direction, and the other again in this direction, when humidity change, the wood stop one each other. So we use play wood for the skin of the instrument, and that is the outside. But the play wood is not so strong for sound, is more for have stability all around the world. Then when we use wood for sound, for example, in the middle here we can see, we use American cedar. The American cedar is a light wood. The weight is low. Have long line, and that means that transmit the sound quickly. And is light and transmitted sound. That is good for go inside the instrument where we should have the resonance.
Of course.
When we go outside of the instrument, for example, this part, you play baton accordion, also who play piano accordion, this part is the very important part for you when you play, when you need to put pressure. You can put the thumb here, you use this part quite a lot. And here, sound is not important because we have no resonance here.
Yeah.
So here we use one wood that is very strong, no long line. The line are very short and are very strong and together. So this is very strong.
Don't break
and
it.
Not
don't break it.
Good for sound.
Okay.
No, we don't break. So here we use, the name is Faggio, now I forget the name in English, but it is a very strong wood. Here, in this part, in baton accordion or in piano accordion, this part again, we have no necessity of sound. The sound is generated inside the instrument, inside the grill, but this part are not important for sound. So we use here a very light wood, very light, and no important that have line. So this have no line because the sound doesn't move here. The sound move inside the instrument.
Okay.
This part where the mechanism is joint is again another kind of wood, because here already we have some transmission of sound, so we need wood with line, but we need to screw also. So we cannot use one wood light and good for sound like American cedar, or like, for example, the classical pine that we use also in violin, that have a very, very long and very narrow line, that is the same wood that is used for violin, for example. Here we have reed block. So in this part, we need to screw, and we need a wood that is mixed on sound, but also on strongness. So already in one small instrument like this, we can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 kind of wood. And we have another small pieces, very small pieces, that is also another kind of wood. And this is a small Piccini secret. So I don't spend
too much
more.
It's a secret that. For the whole world now.
Well, but in a small instrument like this, we have already six different kind of wood. Then when we started to think about reed block that we use in this instrument, and now I take one big reed block like this. Also in reed block, we have almost normally 3 or 4 wood different that we use. For example, this part, the part that is connected to the instrument, then we have the people who know accordion, they know that in here we have the valve. When the valve open, the air go inside and the reeds play. We have one also with the reed here. And of course, when the air go inside, the reeds play. This part of the reed block should be very strong and very stable because is connected with the valve. If this make changement, then the air go through and the tune is not stable. So here we need a lot of stability. Hard wood, no sound. In the middle of the reed block, in the middle, we see, yes, in the middle, we see one soul. The name is soul because this is the soul of the reed block. It's a long piece of wood that go all around the reed block from the beginning to the end. And on this long line are glued all the small parts that divided the reed block. So we have one soul and many soldiers, everyone is here ready to get the reed. And in the top we have another very important part of the reed block. The name is English this morning in English. The main is chief. Like say that is chief, it's not chief, but now I don't, the chief, that go from the beginning to the end. And this also is very important for sound. So we see that in accordion we have wood that are important for sound and wood that are important for stability, wood that should be light. So different kind of wood.
It's so impressive.
Then many times the people ask me why the instrument change his characteristic, his soul, his sound during the time. The reason are many. One of the reason is on the wood. Because when we make this puzzle, we have one piece of wood here that is glued with this part of wood here. We have another piece here that is glued here, another piece here that is glued. So we have all connections that are glued. When the sound starts to move in the instrument, every connection for the sound is a stop, is a because the wood is connected, but it's not one wood, two wood with glue. So every time the sound go around, find one stop, one break. Playing the vibration of the instrument, the vibration of the sound, started to smooth this break, smooth these stops. And so the sound started to go around much quicker, much easily. So if the sound go around much quicker, we have more harmonics. If we have more harmonics, the sound go around much quicker. And that is the good circle that changed the sound of the instrument.
Bravo.
This is one reason. Another reason also is that the artist started to understand the instrument, start to go together with the instrument, and so the difference come out because also how you play is different in the beginning and in the end. So many times when the instrument come with an old instrument in the hand and try a new one instrument, they start to say, oh my God, this instrument is very good, is interesting, but something is missing. Mm-hmm. What is missing is ears.
Yeah.
Instrument without ears is not yet an instrument perfect, an instrument finish.
So interesting. It's amazing. I'm like a child because I never had idea. I'm living on this world since something like 25 years and half a life. I never heard about that. It's very impressive. And on the chat, we have very, very interesting comments by many people. But someone say passionnant et passionné. That means you have this passion and you transmit your passion with your words now, with the way how to build. And it's so logical what you explain. And it's something that I think, I'm not sure that a lot of people knew that. So thank you so much. And one question from Israel, from Victor Aryutkin. Mr. Massimo, what are the voices on the Piginin Nova? What kind of music do you use?
Well, the Nova, the voices, I have also one reed block. The voices can be made in many type, many quality, and many finishing, and many people can do the job. So it's not only a question of which quality I ask, it's not only a question of which material I use, but at the end, the question also, who make the job?
Okay, of course.
It's like in the artist.
Yeah, you're right.
The music is right for everybody. The information is there for everybody. But
understand.
The result is different. So the Nova reeds, especially, they have a special technique for this reed, different of the other. But the really, really difference is
the maker.
The one man and one woman, the couple that make that reed. That is the main difference. To be honest, the reed of one accordion, like the accordion, I repeat, is complicated instrument. The reed of one accordion, we have a big bass like this, and we have a piccolissimo reeds like this. Are different people that make that. So not the same people make, let's say one group of people make the heart of the reeds, specialized people make the bass side, and specialized people make the piccolo side, because are world totally different.
Okay.
Yes, you need expertise, but it's like to play Bach or to play mazurka. Well, you need different spirit.
Exactly. Okay, so Massimo, it's lovely, it's genial, it's super interesting, and thank you so much for your time, because we really learn every week something new, something unexpected, and the way you transmit your passion is fantastic. So see you next week for a new surprise.
See you next week.
Grazie. Bye bye.
And good job, and goodbye to all the accordionists and to all the passionate for music. Ciao, Fred.
Ciao, ciao, Massimo. Thank you. So now we will go to the result of this category of today. Today it's a very particular category. It's something quite new on the history of the Trophée Mondial. Since a few years, we split the Trophée Mondial and the International Open Trophy. We created this International Open Trophy a little bit by accident in 2014. And since this year, it makes a big evolution. And now we have a fantastic panel of different categories from minus 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, plus, and 35 to something more. And after we have the category adults. Why? It's a very egoist what I will say to you, but I discovered the idea of creating that with my fantastic team, Raymond and Anna Baudel. One day that in my parallel life, I was making some international competition of equestrians, and it was one category, more than something, more than 40. And it was some people from 40 to 80 or 70. And I say, wow, that is fantastic. The spirit was genial. I said, I want the same for accordion. And we have, and we have. So let's have with us Raymond Baudel. Hello, Raymond. How are you since yesterday night?
Good morning, Fred. Good morning, everybody. Well, I slept well, and so we're back for another fun day. Results as well as interviews and wonderful music. So really excited day. It'll be an exciting day, I'm sure.
So
you asked the results for this morning. We have the results, as you are saying, for our first of the two adult classes. We have the adults, passionate, amateur category. And again, just a quick rundown. We had an international jury for this category of Elton Bala from Albania, Ravi Ben from India, Natalie Boucher from France, Andy Coles from the United Kingdom, Elsa Goudi from France, Bomareza Sayed Hassani from Iran, Nikolai Ovchennikov from Russia, Natalie Shak from Belarus, Senka Todorova from Bulgaria, and Sergio Sampoli from South Africa. So, as usual, a pretty diverse and wide-ranging number of countries and parts of the world represented for our adults in this category, in which there were 11 contestants. So I, as usual, will say I presume you are ready to display the results of the category, which, of course, will go online. Up to prize winners.
Yeah, it's done. I will just adapt a little bit. Yes, perfectly. So that are the result. Yeah, but I need to reduce from that screen, then people can see everything. It's perfect. Okay, so now you can see the result from the place 11th to the 6th one.
Exactly.
That's done.
So I start off in fifth place. And in fifth place came from France, Muriel Dugard.
Yeah, and I killed a little bit the surprise. I killed a little bit the surprise because during the time I was looking at something, we listened, no, and I think she recognized her. Love for demo. So, points?
Points for Muriel were 21.88 in fifth place.
Okay, so we listen immediately this wonderful composition from Claude Thomas, L'Enfant Démon, played by Mireille Dugard at the fifth place.
Thank you.
such a lovely interpretation of L'Enfant Démon by the fifth place of this adult amateur passionné, Mireille Dugard. And then, naturally, we go to the fourth place with suspense.
Fourth place, again from France, with a score of 21.94, was Martine Millier.
Martine Millier. Mia, je pense. Ou Millier, je ne sais pas. Ça dépend si on a fait des fautes d'orthographe ou pas. Elle n'en a pas fait, elle. Ah, why you speak French? Because it's a French one. No, it's Martine Mia because she wrote herself her name on the YouTube link. So it must not be any kind of mistake. We listen the composition she chose, La Valse à Margot from Richard Galliano, godfather of the CMA, of course. La Valse à Margot, composed by Richard Galliano, of course, and played by Martine Millier at the fourth place. And now we arrive to the top three. Ta-dum.
Top three, drum roll time, and we go above 22. We move to 22.12 in third place, and come from Germany, Angie Hirsch. So congratulations to Germany.
Again, a woman. Will we have a man after? And we don't know. Suspense. Let's listen. She will. She's playing already. And I think, my friend, you will agree with me that this is also Confédération Mondiale de l'Accordéon that must show all the population of the accordion in the world, the top, the smallest, and also these amateurs who have this place on the accordion field. And it's fantastic to see how they practice, how they perform, how difficult it has been to make videos. It's genial.
The passion they have, it is very interesting. And as I say, it's interesting how diverse. And of course, we come now to diversity because we go out of Europe for our prize winners. of second and first place. We go out of Europe for both places. And in second place, they've got a few prizes so far in this trophy, Mondial International Open Trophy. But with a score of 22.59, it goes to China. A surprise there. With Lu Ning.
Lu Ning, that will perform for us. I wrote it somewhere, but not here. Something quite interesting title is A Fight, the Tiger Up the Mountain. So let's see how this Lu Ning fights the tiger up the mountain with an accordion. Was a way to fight the tiger up to the mountain, and now we arrive to the first place that should join us in Zoom, but I think they have a small problem because they are not so close, that close, and effectively they try to phone me by video, but it's not the way. I don't know how I will do if I have them on the video. So my vice president, please.
Okay, so our winners of this category, this adults amateurs category with 22.67, they come from India, and woo-hoo, it is Badri Vital. So winners from India.
And he will play, surprisingly, Made in India, Tico Tico. So I hope that during the time we listen, he will arrive and the delegate too, Ravi Bene. Let's see. Listen, Tico Tico.
Thank you.
That was Vital Badri from India, and our friends from India are fighting now to try to get on Zoom, but it looked like it's more complicated than expected. It's live. And anyway, we will have our guest from India during a Facebook Live show before the end of the year. And of course, we will invite this winner just to say how happy he is to win. So what is the program for tonight with the categories and tomorrow, dear Vice President of the CMA?
Well, tonight we have a very special show. I'm sure everybody will be excited to hear about tonight's show, because not only have we the results of one of the bigger categories of the Trophy Mondial, certainly I think competitive-wise, certainly the biggest. We had over 50 contestants playing in the Trophy Mondial Masters. And of course, you know, 20-minute programs with a jury of 23, 24 in the jury. It's been a big category for everybody. A lot of listening, as we heard from our guest last night, Martinus Navitskas. A lot of variety. It'll be a great result. But of course, we've also got this evening a wonderful presentation about the Premium Trophy Mondial for 2021, live from Truskovets in Ukraine, our venue next November. So it is very much a special show tonight. Really looking forward to it. I'm sure everybody will be, to see what the plans are, the venue and everything for the Trophy Mondial next year, as well as I say, the results of the Masters category. Big show tonight. Briefly, tomorrow results, we have the other amateur category, the amateur confirmé category result tomorrow morning. And tomorrow night, another big result, the Trophy Mondial Junior Classique, the result of a two-round competition. 14 contestants from the original 33 were selected to play the second round and be listened to by the international jury for the second round. And of course, as we all know, you might come first in the first round, but you don't always make first in the second round. And the results really are quite interesting to see, I can assure everybody, as I'm in the middle of calculation of those. So lots to happen tonight and tomorrow.
Great. So tonight we will have Andriy Dushny, our delegate from Ukraine, Igor Sayenko, our delegate from Ukraine, the mayor of the city of Truskovets, that will be the Trophy Mondial Premium next year, the rector of the academy, the boss of the boss, Dushny, plus Yaroslav Oleksiv. That we are very lucky, because it's Christmas before Christmas, because today we have Artem Nizhnik as fantastic composer, and Yaroslav Oleksiv is fantastic composer too, we will listen tonight. Tomorrow morning, Pietro Roffi from Italy will be with us. And tomorrow night, Semyon Shmelkov from Gnesin Academy. Again, a super jury and a previous winner of Trophy Mondial, Coupe Mondial, Klingenthaler, whatever. So we will finish that Facebook Live show with one more composition of Artem Nizhnik, because he sent to me so many, and I said, okay, we cannot on the first part, but one I wanted absolutely to show again with this duet, Sib duo from Siberia. They are playing now the fourth movement, the finale of Maktub from Artem Nizhnik. It's absolutely fantastic composition. Say hello to Anna and have a nice lunch, and see you tonight, my friend. Bye.
Excellent.
Bye.
Ciao. Yeah, bye.
Thank you.